This is the must-have Google Apps for business growth. And if you're a business owner trying to make sense of all the different tools that Google has, because there are a lot, then this is going to be useful for you because we really want you to take advantage of the best tools that are there for businesses. Let me take you through some of the best tools and my favorite ones for growing and scaling your business that you must be using as you go along your business journey. My first tool that you must be using for your business is Google My Business. And even if you are not a local services business, and you know by that I mean you know a hairdresser or a restaurant or something that people are actually going to be navigating and directing to in a physical space, even if you're not that kind of business, you should still really be using this. And that's because Google wants to make people's lives easier by displaying and organizing all of the world's information. That is their mission. And so if a user is searching for your business or a business like your business, well, Google wants to tell them a bit about what businesses are available. And the kind of businesses that have a completed Google My Business profile, Google is actually going to give them a little bit of a bump in the search results. And that's because they can actually display better information for their customers. The user of the web search gets a better experience, and therefore Google wants to prioritize a better experience for their customers. Now, this is also a great way to build so much social capital with your customers immediately when they haven't even gotten in touch with your business through reviews. And let me tell you, there is a magic number of reviews when you build your business and you build your five-star reviews that will make your Google results absolutely skyrocket. And I'll tell you, it's in the hundreds, but I won't tell you the exact number. But basically, when you're building reviews in your business, Google also sees your business as favorable to giving people a good experience. And so they're going to recommend that business higher as well. But imagine you're a customer and, you know, if you're looking for a restaurant and you see something that's got only two or three reviews, it's kind of not very much data. And you may think to yourself, yeah, you know what, I'll go somewhere that maybe has a lower star rating, but has a better data set. Maybe it's got 100 reviews or it's got 200 reviews. So let me tell you, working on the reviews in your business will really, really help your Google ranking. But not only that, it's going to help the perception of your customers when you're actually allowing them to come and find your business online. Now, how do you get reviews? Simple. You ask for them. Really simple script is to say, hey, Mr. Customer, we would really love to know what you thought about the experience of working with us. If it's worth 5 stars, that's amazing. Please give us 5 stars. But if it's anything less than 5 stars, hey, please just hit reply to this email and let me know what you think we could do to be 5 stars for you. That little email script works wonders. We've been using it for years and years and years, and we've been able to amass hundreds and hundreds of 5-star reviews on our profile. Go check it out. If you Google IT Genius, you'll see them all there. And that builds a lot of trust when we actually have customers attracted to our business. The next tool I want to share with you is called Think with Google. And I'll be completely upfront with you. I had no idea that this existed until my producers showed this to me on the slide deck just an hour ago. And this is actually an amazing project from Google. And it's actually helping marketing teams and marketing executives to understand more about the landscape, particularly in a post-COVID world. Remember that Google are in essence primarily a marketing company. Still 80 to 90% of their revenue comes from their advertising and search business. And so Google are in the business of educating business owners and marketing executives on how to build better businesses and how to market better. So if you check out this amazing tool, it's called Think with Google. You can see there's consumer insights, marketing strategies, future of marketing. This is really all about training and increasing your competency as a marketer, and there's plenty of great resources there. Of course, you can go and pay for courses, or you can go and talk to gurus, but Google have got some really, really great stuff, and I did have a quick check out of it myself, and there's some excellent things there. One of the best tools for marketers is to use the tool of Google Trends. And this is more if you're a bit more on the speculative side or you really want to keep a finger on what's going on in the search world or what's popular right now. Google Trends basically allows you to see what is being searched for in the Google algorithm and Google's tools. And so that what that lets you do is potentially shape your strategy around where you're going to take your business and what kind of market trends you want to adapt to in the strategy that you're going through. The next tool that I love is Google Data Studio, and we've built a whole team of developers specifically to build amazing business dashboards for business owners. If you're interested in that, please make sure to get in touch with our team because we can really do some amazing things with visualizing business data using Google Data Studio. So what does it look like? Well, this is Data Studio. It's basically a live and dynamic business dashboard, which allows you to show all of the numbers that are going on in your business. Now, this is a report from YouTube. We don't seem to have any other slides. That's okay. We just have the one report here. Editors will need to clean that up, please. We've got the ability to have all of your data shown online and downloaded and visualized in real time. So you might pull your sales from Xero.com. You might pull your advertising spend from Google Ads. You might pull your customer data from your CRM system and have all of that available in one place. And if you choose to, you can even put it up on a TV somewhere in your office and from there see everything that's going on in the business live and in real time. Some of the other great features of Data Studio are the ability to use a date picker and actually drill down and do some business intelligence analysis on your data. And what that allows you to do is see exactly what's going on in the business and from there make better business decisions. Now, we're all about data-driven business decisions here because that's one of the key skills for small business owners to learn as they grow and scale their business. The next tool on my list of favorites is Google Analytics. And this is not just to see how many hits you're getting on your website, because everyone's done that. Google also now have some pretty advanced tools around conversion optimization and visualizing the funnel of leads coming to your website. And what I really love about this is, usually these tools would cost like hundreds of dollars a month to track all the conversions and where are they happening and what pages do I need to improve. But now that Google's actually created this inside Google Analytics, this is available for free for all business users. And so if you've got Google Analytics, you can access goals. And then this is actually called like the goal funnel, which actually shows you the flow of conversion between each of your different tools. Now, for each one of your customers, it actually shows you the flow of conversion for each one of your customers. Thank you so much for joining. If you have any further questions, just drop below in the comments and I'll be there to help you guys out. I will see you in the next one. Just remember, we've got videos pretty much every Thursday. Make sure you're on our email list and you'll get access to those. If you haven't already joined our Facebook group, the community, you can jump in there because we do a video every second week in there, more aimed at businesses already in the Google ecosystem, in the Google world. Now, it should go without saying that if you're a business owner, you should be using Google Workspace. This is Google's suite of collaboration tools for everything small business. File storage, communication, collaboration, security, connection with your team, policies, and all in one place to be able to connect and communicate, collaborate with your team effectively. Now, we are the number one partner for Australia and New Zealand for Google Workspace, and we've helped literally thousands of businesses get set up and get productive in the Google Workspace ecosystem. If you're already a customer of Workspace, I'm sure we can help you to get more out of your investment. And if you're not yet a part of the Google ecosystem, well, then it might be time to investigate that. Either way, make sure you get in touch with our team. Now, Google Workspace gives you the ability to switch away from the consumer version of Google, which is your email address at gmail.com, and actually use a professional business name in the Google ecosystem. And what that means is that you are able to use all of Google's tools in a professional environment, and you've got an admin panel where you can add and remove users and have full control of all the data and all of the happenings inside your business domain. If you're interested in that, then please be sure to reach out to our team.